Hi students, welcome to this video module. So in this module, we are going to discuss stress management. So let me just look at so far what happened in the organizational behavior. We have discussed certain important issues which are very much related to individual, and those dimensions like attitude, personality, then perception, the transaction analysis, all these are very useful to understand individual behavior. At the same time, how individual is developing relations with others, and how actually the Johari window helps us to know about ourselves and then know about others in terms of disclosing information as much as possible. So these are the issues we have discussed so far, and then in this module, so let me just look at the stress management. The stress management is equally important at workplace, because so in between manager and then followers, you'll find the existence of stress. So in this context, so let me just look at the stress management. What is this the stress management, how it is existing in the organizations, and then different sources of the stress. So all those things we'll discuss, and then in this module, so let me just focus on the important issues. It is to know about what is stress, and then what are the different types, and then so why the stress is there at the organization, and what is the loss of loss for the organization when there is stress among the employees. So let me just look at why to manage stress, or why should we give importance for stress at the organizational context. If you look at the cost of the stress in the workplace, so US employees, you'll find that loss is $1 billion, right? So it is because of loss of the productivity and increased healthcare expenses and increased absenteeism and increased accidents. All these are the reasons for giving importance for stress at workplace. So if you just see the cost of stress, so 80% of all modern diseases have their origin in stress. So whatever the disease that you talk about organizational context, so almost all, so 80% the source is stress. In the UK, 40 million working days per year are lost directly from stress related illnesses. So because the stress is there, and the stress is inevitable at workplace, when the stress is there, so how the people are just coping with the stress and then handling the stress. If they are not able to handle the stress, so that is going to affect negatively the individual at the workplace, and then that is negatively influence the output. So the cost in the absenteeism to British industry is estimated at US pounds 1.5 billions per year. So in that way, you can see that how the stress is actually affecting the organizations. So then let us look at what is the stress is all about. So Hans Seely, MD, is defined or explained about the stress is the non-specific response of the body to any demand, right? Whether it is caused by or resulted in the pleasant or unpleasant condition. So you'll find that there is a kind of response from our body in our system. So that actually the caused by the the result of the pleasant or unpleasant conditions, whatever it may be, the the effect that is there in our internal and external system, so there is a kind of a response so from our body. So that response is called a kind of the stress, right? So then if you look at the further, the stress is the wear and tear. For example, the stress will come and then go, right? So in our mind, so that is there, so in most of the conditions. So you'll find that the body's experience as we attempt to cope with our continually changing environment. So the stress is there always, and then stress happens continuously with our system, right? So further, if you just see that the stress is your mind and body response or reaction to a real or imaginary threat, even or change. So anything that happens with us in our life, so there is a kind of the feel of the stress that is there in our body, right? So the threat, event, or a change or commonly called stressors. So whatever that threat is there, the event that happens, so that is what we call stressors. Stressors can be internal, maybe that is related to our thoughts and beliefs and attitude. Even sometimes our thoughts are the stressors. So our attitude is a stress, right? Our belief system also is stress. If you believe strongly certain things, if that is not happening, then you feel stress, right? So like that, you can see the internally there are stressors within one individual. So then if you look at the external stressors, like a loss of something and tragedy or any the major incidents that happens in our life, so all these are the stressors. So in that way, you can see the stressors, you know, that is there all the times with us. So if you just look at the further the definition of the stress, the stress occurs when the pressure is greater than the resources. So that means, you can see that the stress is equal to pressure is greater than the response. Our response is weak and then pressure is more, then you feel the stress, right? For any incident or for any news or any anything that happens with us in our life, in day-to-day activities, so always you will find that you feel the stress. For example, if I just announce the test exam, within 1 day, right? So you feel the stress because of the information that you are receiving. So the exam date, so that actually the date of exam is a stressor. So that actually affecting you, and then you feel that the pressure is more than the response. So there is existence of stress in your body. So in that way, you can see that the stress is happening with us. So is all stress bad? This is another important question. So the stress is bad or good? So the moderate level of stress may actually improve the performance and then efficiency. So the stress is important and stress is required some extent. So when the stress is there, we feel active and then energetic, right? So we are alert if the stress is there. So the too little stress may result in the boredom and will become lazy if there is no stress, right? So too much stress may cause and then unproductive anxiety level. So you can see that if the too much stress, that is the stress pressure is more than our internal response, so then negatively affect the our body. So then one type of the stress is called EU stress. So EU stress or a positive stress occurs when your level of stress is high enough to motivate you to move into action to get things accomplished. So when there is a stress, EU stress, if that is actually motivating us and activating us and enable us to complete the task, so that is what we call EU stress. So this stress is good for every individual to perform better. So the another the side of the stress is called distress. So distress or negative stress occurs when the level of stress is either too high or too low, and body and mind begins to respond negatively to the stressors. So when there is stress, definitely there is a response within us. So when the response is there, so when our body is negatively responding to that, mind and body, because the pressure is more than our internal resistance. So in that case, so that negative stress will result the negative way in our body, right? So this is all about the concepts and then the basic the meaning of what is stress and how the stress is there. So the types of stress, like DU stress and EU stress. So this way you can just understand the basic the concept and then definition of the stress. So let me stop here, and then we will meet again in video 66 to discuss further about the stress. Thank you.